A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13th June, on the front page you have Coimbatore men are held for ties with Easter attack mastermind. So the National Investigation Agency is investigating, and it has targeted 6-member module propagating Islamic State ideology on social media, and this has been apprehended. You can see this is Zahran Hasim. So this was the person who has been named to be the main accused in the Sri Lankan Easter bomb attacks. So, the prime suspect in this case from India is Muhammad Asharuddin and his associates. So, it is said they were propagating the idea and they were in contact with the Sri Lankan Easter bomb attacker. Then next is 5 CRPF jawans killed in militant attack in Kashmir. So, this is a militant attack which took place in Jammu and Kashmir, and 5 CRPF jawans were killed. And this is neither Azadi nor autonomy possible. So this is Jammu and Kashmir Governor Satyapal Malik, who said that the ruling elite involved in corruption in the state will face action soon, and said that youth should give up arms because neither Azadi nor autonomy was possible. Then below you have retail inflation at 7-month high of 3.05%. So retail inflation has moved marginally up to 3.05%, mainly due to rise in food prices and notably vegetable prices. So this is a 7-month high. Inflation in April was at 2.99%. And also you should know that RBI, when it decides its repo rate, it has inflation targeting. So it is the retail inflation CPI, consumer price index based inflation, which it targets. And it targets it to maintain inflation at 4%, because very low inflation also shows that growth is not sufficient in the economy. So there needs to be more growth. So this value of 3.05% and 2.99% are below target. That is why recently we saw RBI also reduce the repo rate to boost the economy. So that's the case. Of course, RBI has 4% inflation targeting with plus minus 2% range as such allowed. Then on page 8 you have Chandrayaan 2 to be launched on July 15 from Sriharikota. So this is India's second mission to the moon. Preparation is on. And this is Kerala to have its own open university. So it is said all distance education private registration programs of Kerala will come under one roof. So it will have its own private own open university. Then on page 9 you have DRDO tests technology demonstrator. So this is hypersonic technology demonstrator vehicle HSTDV. So this has been successfully tested by Defense Research and Development Organization. So this will have multiple civilian uses too. You can see in this technology demonstrator, what has happened is that number of technologies have been proved. So DRDO has not given details about what the technology demonstrator was or was such, but it has said that the critical technologies for futuristic missions have been tested. So there was a missile which was successfully launched and tracked by various radars, telemetry stations and electro-optical tracking sensors through its course. Then below you have enforcement of child labor laws lacking. So this is an article which talks of how child labor is still prevalent in India, and it is because implementation of laws at state and district level have been lacking. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Values to Live By. So this editorial talks of how PM's call for inclusiveness in Maldives and Sri Lanka is relevant in India too. And this is Starting at 3. So this is regarding extending right to education to younger children. So that editorial says this is a welcome step. So this is mentioned in the draft education policy, the national education policy as such, which has been discussed in news. The lead article, a summary of fears and possibilities. So this article talks of why Narendra Modi government should be cautious about the majoritarian agenda. So the counter effects of that are discussed here. And this is back to Kashmir with an open heart. So this article says that any delay in the legislative assembly elections in Jammu and Kashmir will only deepen the sense of alienation. So you should know that Jammu and Kashmir is presently under president's rule. It was earlier under governor's rule, now under president's rule, and elections have not taken place for assembly, legislative assembly here. So this is an article talking of how there's a need to hold assembly elections in Delhi, in Jammu and Kashmir, without any delay. Then on the op-ed page you have navigations in Bishkek. So this article is in the context of SCO summit, Shanghai Cooperation Organization summit. It says that the regional aspirations of Central Asian countries contradict India's goals. So it is said that India will have to navigate between two contradictory imperatives. It says, while on the one hand it must act as a willing partner for regional cooperation, as such, on the other, it must avoid being seen as part of the anti-American gang. So that is one concern which India has to be cautious about. And the other thing is that India wants to fight against terrorism through a body that includes states that pose biggest threats to Indian society, it is said. So that is the contradiction at SCO. On page 12, you have triple talaq bill to be sent to parliament again. So cabinet has approved the triple talaq bill, which will replace the ordinance, and it will be introduced in the upcoming session in the new Lok Sabha. Other bills also you can see are mentioned here, like the Aadhaar will be now as ID proof for banks and telecom companies. So Union cabinet has approved a bill on this to allow voluntary submission of Aadhaar as identity proof. And this is Indian Medical Council Amendment Bill. This has also been cleared by the cabinet. Also, another bill is Homeopathy Central Council Bill. So both have been cleared by the cabinet. They had lapsed in the 16th Lok Sabha because the bills were pending and they had not been passed. And this is eviction from government residences to be quicker. So Union cabinet has also cleared amendments to Public Premises Eviction of Unauthorized Occupants Act 1971. And then on page 13 you have Pakistan airspace won't be used for Modi's flight to SCO. So earlier we had seen how India had requested Pakistan to allow Modi's flight over Pakistan airspace, but now it is said that Prime Minister Narendra Modi would not fly over using Pakistan's airspace. He will fly via Oman, Iran and Central Asian countries. Then on international page here you have coverage regarding the Hong Kong protests. So the extradition bill, which talks of extradition of people from Hong Kong to Chinese mainland territory. So such bill has triggered unrest and police are firing tear gas and rubber bullets at the crowd. Then below you have China launches internet cleanup campaign. So China has launched a campaign to clean up its internet, and fresh wave of apparent censorship thus should be expected. So they have started this rectification effort in May 2019. Then on business page you have industrial growth recovers, CPI inflation up. So this is regarding IIP and CPI data. So food prices have increased because of CPI, which is CPI inflation is also high now. And this is debt downgrades at a record high. So mutual funds have large exposure to such instruments, and this is going to affect their net asset value now. And this is Jalan panel report on RBI reserves by June end. So this is Bimal Jalan committee, which is looking into the size of capital reserves that RBI should hold. So banks have 9.6 lakh crore surplus capital presently, and earlier we had seen how government wanted a share in this surplus capital. So RBI set up this committee, and the Vimal Jalan committee report as such will come. It's a 6-member panel under former RBI governor Vimal Jalan. It was appointed in December 2018 to review it, as it is called, the economic capital framework of Reserve Bank of India. So here you can see how finance ministry wanted RBI to follow global best practices and transfer more surplus to the government, but RBI refused. So now this is a body set up which will give its report in June end. And on the last page you have, survey reveals 86% of internet users fall victim to fake news. So lion's share of blame for the spread of lies is in USA, followed by Russia and then China. So fake news are maximum from these three countries. And here you have, Big B pays off loans of 2,100 Bihar farmers. So Amitabh Bachchan said that he helped paying off outstanding loans of over 2,000 farmers from Bihar. And this is how much plastic is in your diet. So it is said people are ingesting 5 grams of microplastic every week, equal in weight to a credit card. So this is a study which highlights these details. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.